Divine Chaplet, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead, and on the third day rose again from the dead, ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. Resurrection body and life everlasting. Amen. Eternal Father, we offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us, O Lord.
Eternal Father, we offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
Eternal Father, we offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
Eternal Father, we offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
mercy on us.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and the whole world. For the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Eternal Father, we offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. In our prayer before Mass, Eternal Father, unite myself with the intentions and affections of our greatest souls in the heaven. I offer to you the sacrifice which thy beloved Son made himself on the cross, and which he now renews on this holy altar. I offer in the name of all mankind, as a Mass which is now being offered, and all those which we offer throughout the world this day, to adore thee and to give thee the honor which is due to thee, confessing thy supreme dominion over all things, and the absolute dependence of everything upon thee, who art our last end, to thank thee for
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of the Lord be with you. Good morning. On this day we come before the Lord, we ask that the mysteries of Easter, the salvation it brings, be light in our hearts. We begin by asking the Lord for his pardon and his peace. Lord Jesus, you came into the world to raise us up to the heavens. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, by being raised upon the cross, you prepared the resurrection. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You send the Holy Spirit to guide us in your ways. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who open wide the gates of the heavenly kingdom to those reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, pour out on your servants an increase of the grace you have bestowed, that having been purged of all sins, they may lack nothing, that in your kindness you have promised, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen said to the people, the elders and the scribes, "You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always oppose the Holy Spirit. You are just like your ancestors. Which of your prophets did your ancestors not persecute? They put to death those who foretold the coming of the righteous one, whose betrayers and murderers you have now become. You received the law as transmitted by angels, but you did not observe it." When they heard this, they were infuriated and they ground their teeth at him. But Stephen, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked up intently to heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And Stephen said, "Behold, I see the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. Behold, I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out in a loud voice, covered their ears, and rushed upon him together. They threw him out of the city and began to stone him. The witnesses laid down their cloaks at the feet of the young man named Saul. As they were stoning Stephen, he called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell to his knees and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And when he said this, he fell asleep. Now Saul was consenting to his execution. The word of the Lord. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. You are my rock and my fortress. For your name's sake, you will lead and guide me.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God. My trust is in the Lord. I will rejoice and be glad of your mercy.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Let your face shine upon your servant, save me in your kindness. You hide them in the shelter of your presence from the plottings of men.
So Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. So they said to Jesus, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you.
People have all kinds of ways of looking at the world, all kinds of ways of responding to the opportunities and the challenges that are presented. And in the first reading, we have an example of Stephen's way. It is a way that illustrates Christ, who is the bread of life. The way Stephen saw things was something that got him not only past the awkwardness of telling the people things that they did not wish to hear, things that had truth with them, when he called them stiff-necked people, uncircumcised of heart and ears. But this view, this understanding, this way of being, was something that moved Stephen even into focusing on the heavens opening and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God, even when the people were throwing him out of the city and in their rage were arranging to kill him. It's quite an understanding. It packs quite a punch. It's able to withstand things that most people don't really think are possible. And so, we come to the Easter view of the world. We come to the view of the world that sees what Christ has done, how he died and how he rose, and how he is the bread of life. And in him, whoever believes will never thirst. Whoever comes to him will never be hungry. We see Stephen living that out, even dying that out, so as to live it out in a more complete way. Thank you. Finding hope and light in Christ, we ask that he hear our prayers and guide us in his way.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Danny Maisley. For this intention, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For the Church, the people of God, may we, with the help of the Holy Spirit, continue to grow in the likeness of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may God bless their efforts to work for the betterment of all whom they serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may they be comforted by the Lord's abiding presence and his redemption of their suffering. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers.
For all who work for life, especially those who pray at abortion clinics, that God may reward them for their prayers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers.
For the safety of military personnel, peacekeepers, and humanitarian workers who risk their lives in the service of justice, peace, and national security, and also for the well-being of their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For the commissioned Stephen ministers, caregivers, and our parish community, may the light of the Holy Spirit guide them to follow in the footsteps of Jesus, the caregiver. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died, including Helen Milovich, for whom Our Lady of Candle burns this week, may God, who is merciful, shower his mercy upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our personal intentions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Lord God, help us in this season of Easter to understand the words of your Son that he is the bread of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have
perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to loud jubilate yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment. In reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord. God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Thursday, there will be a funeral. It starts at 10 with the rosary, and then the mass at 11. So the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament on Thursday will be after the funeral, which will probably be about 12:15 or 12:30. Thank you. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
compass of the scourge and of the bitter. I desire further of mortification. Think of the cruel scourge and of the bitter of the Lord suffering, the heavy blows of Thor's flesh. Let us pray the second part of all the souls of purgatory, especially the souls